Hi there, my name is Sam from Rose.com and welcome to a new comparison video between the Apple iPhone 12 Pro Max and the 11 Pro Max. We are comparing both phones in terms of display, performance, camera, design and battery. Stay tuned and find out if it's worth the upgrade to the newer version. If you'd like to see more videos like this, feel free to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Let's start straight away with our review. Let the facts speak.
Display.
The iPhone 11 Pro Max has a 6.5-inch display with a 2688x1242 pixel resolution. It uses an OLED screen to create very natural colors. The 6.5-inch display therefore measures 16.5cm diagonally with a pixel density of 458 ppi. Since this phone was released in 2019, it doesn't have the 2020 must-have of a 120Hz refresh rate. Well, that was the iPhone 11 Pro Max's display. Now let's take a closer look at the iPhone 12 Pro Max's display. The iPhone 12 Pro Max has a 6.7-inch display with a 1284p resolution. The 6.7-inch display therefore measures 17cm diagonally with a pixel density of 458 ppi. The iPhone's OLED screen creates as usual very natural colors. The refresh rate on the iPhone 12 Pro Max is 60Hz. Apple didn't see the need to improve the displays in terms of the refresh rate. The 12 Pro Max still comes with 60Hz. However, Apple decreased the bezels, which increases the display size. The 12 Pro Max also has a slightly higher resolution than the 11 Pro Max. Those really small improvements let the iPhone 12 Pro Max win in this category.
Performance. The iPhone 11 Pro Max is equipped with Apple's A13 Bionic chip. The phone has 4GB RAM and the individual models offer different storage capacities. 64, 256 and 512GB are available. Storage capacity unfortunately cannot be expanded as it is typical for Apple iPhone devices.
So much for the performance specs of the 11 Pro Max. Next up, the specs of the new generation. The iPhone 12 Pro Max is equipped with Apple's A14 Bionic chip. The phone has 6GB RAM and the individual models offer different storage capacities. 128, 256 and 512GB are available. Storage capacity unfortunately cannot be expanded as it is typically for Apple iPhone devices. The 12 Pro Max has with 6GB slightly more GB RAM than its predecessor. Its A14 Bionic chip has also a new process technology, which makes the new iPhone quite strong. We bring them into the Antutu benchmark test to find out how the performance improved.
The tests are divided into three phases. A performance test of the RAM, a test of how the device is handling two-dimensional graphics, and an endurance test of how the device is handling 3D graphics.
As you can see, the 5nm process technology in the new iPhone 12 Pro Max clearly let it outperform the iPhone 11 Pro Max. Therefore, its successor takes home the win in this performance category.
Camera. The iPhone 11 Pro Max has three main cameras. All three cameras have a resolution of 12 megapixel. The front camera's resolution is 12 megapixel. The iPhone 11 Pro Max records 4K videos at a maximum of 60 frames per second. Also has image stabilization for video.
At first glance, not much has changed. See for yourself. The iPhone 12 Pro Max has a triple rear camera system. It features a 12 megapixel ultrawide, a 12 megapixel wide, and a 12 megapixel telephoto camera. The front camera resolution is also 12 megapixel. The iPhone 12 Pro Max records 4K videos at a maximum of 60 frames per second. And of course, it has image stabilization for video. The 12 Pro Max also has a sensor shift optical image stabilization for its wide angle camera. Both phones have good camera systems, but which one is actually the better system? Let's take it to our camera test and let's find out which one does a better job. It seems like no big changes were made in the new iPhone. Both phones take really sharp pictures with accurate color rendering, but there are still differences. The next generation of Apple Smart HDR, which the iPhone 12 Pro Max has, improved the smallest details by deciding which part of the picture should be more exposed than others. And they gave the camera system a new lens, which lets in more light, which helps it to improve taking better pictures or videos, especially in nighttime conditions. The new Pro Series from Apple has also the new LiDAR scanner feature built in, which improves augmented reality possibilities and the night protection models. When it comes to the zoom feature, the iPhone 11 Pro Max has a 2-fold optical and a 10-fold digital zoom, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max got a 5-fold optical and a 12-fold digital zoom feature. Again, a small improvement. Both phones produce excellent videos with a resolution of 4K with up to 60 frames and slow motion videos in HD mode with up to 240 frames per second. But there's a difference. It's again in the details. The 12 Pro Max uses Dolby HDR in videos, in which you get way more information that can be adjusted without losing quality. And also, the image stabilization got an improvement in the new iPhone 12 series. If you're mostly shooting in daylight conditions, you might not notice a significant difference, but you definitely notice a difference in nighttime conditions. Overall, we think that the iPhone 12 Pro Max has definitely improved, which is why it wins here and get the point of the camera system comparison.
Design. The iPhone 11 Pro Max with Apple's signature glossy and matte finish has a very high-end look and feel to it. The triple cameras are well positioned on the upper left corner on the back of the phone. The smartphone weighs 226 grams and it's roughly 15.8 cm long, 7.78 cm wide and 0.81 cm deep. It has Apple's Lightning connector and is IP68 rated, so it's water and dust resistant. The iPhone uses the face recognition technology to unlock the phone.
We really love the design of the iPhone 12 Pro Max, but the iPhone 12 Pro Max's new design has its own appeal. Let's take a look at it. The iPhone 12 Pro Max has a glossy stainless steel frame and a matte glass finish on the back. Typically for Apple, it has a very high-end look and feel to it. The triple cameras are well positioned on the upper left corner on the back of the phone. The smartphone weighs 228 grams. It's roughly 16 cm long, 7.81 cm wide and 0.74 cm deep. It uses Apple's Lightning connector and is IP68 rated, so it's water and dust resistant. And it is supposed to be 4 times more drop resistant than previous models. The iPhone uses face recognition technology to unlock the phone. The Face ID, as usual, works perfect at daylight and also good in a weak light environment. Like we mentioned in our comparison between the iPhone 12 Pro and the 11 Pro Max, the design question is a question that is led by personal preferences. Some argue that the new design is a step back to an old design, and other people actually like exactly that about it. We decided to call it a draw because our team was divided in team new design and team old design. I personally like the new design, especially because of the improved haptics. Let us know what side you are on. Do you like the old or the new design? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to tell us why.
Battery.
The 12 Pro Max, when fully charged, has around 3,687 mAh. On the other hand, the 11 Pro Max, when fully charged, has 3,969 mAh. In terms of capacity, Apple decided to decrease the battery size. Let us find out whether that was a good or bad idea in our day-to-day usage test. It was close, but the 11 Pro Max lasted longer, which is quite frustrating, as we expected more from the new phone. We expected an improvement, not a deterioration. So the point goes to the 11 Pro Max. But as always though, both phones got through a full day of normal usage. It always depends on the way you use your phone and the settings you use it in.
Conclusion.
Alright, that's it for now. Next, we are going to count the points to find out if the iPhone 11 Pro Max actually can keep up with the new iPhone 12 Pro Max. Let's start with the display. The first point went to the 12 Pro Max, since not by much, but there were a few adjustments that improved the display. The next point also went to the successor. Due to the new processor technology and the A14 Bionic chip, the 12 Pro Max performed way better, and the 12 Pro Max also scored again in the camera system category. But in the design category, we gave both phones a point, because we had different opinions about the new design. The last, and in this case not least, is once again the battery life category, which sadly the iPhone 11 Pro Max won. Sadly, because we expected more. The overall winner hereby is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. So what if you have the iPhone 11 Pro Max? Is it worth upgrading to the 12 Pro Max? Probably not. I mean, it depends. If you really want to have the newest technology in your phone, like the LiDAR scanner or the slightly improved camera, and you have the money laying around, go ahead. But other than that, I'd say you're still more than up to date with your iPhone 11 Pro Max. Naturally, we review more than these 5 categories covered here. If you want to see the full comparison, follow the link to our website. You can compare up to 7 different smartphones at versus.com. But before you do that, please post your comments and let us know which phone you think ranks first. If you liked our video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Till then, take care and see you soon.